Welcome back for another movie review. And of course, now I'm gonna talk about Superman 4, the Quest for Peace. More the Quest for Crap, or the Quest for Peace, Rest in Peace, or something. Oh my god, this movie was god awful. This movie fucking sucks. It so badly sucks. It's so bad movie. This is just bad movie, cheap effects, cheap, terrible story, terrible plot lines, plot holes, lines. The effects are god awful. The acting performance, everyone's god awful, terrible. This is actually my final review, and of course the final movie I'm reviewing for Superman. I'm done with Superman franchise, and obviously, the first movie obviously loves everyone. Everyone obviously loves the first movie, everyone loves. I love the first one to death. It's my personal favorite Superman movie of all time. I love Superman the movie to death. Superman 2, a lot of people hate the film because it's Richard Lester, not Richard Donner. But Superman 2 is my favorite Superman movie. Superman the movie is my second favorite. They're both my favorite movies of all time. Superman 3 gets crap on it. Superman 3, it's my fourth favorite Superman film. I love Superman 3 to death. This movie makes Superman 3 a masterpiece. Man of Steel, I love to death. It's my third favorite Superman movie. It's a reboot. Supergirl, it's my fifth favorite Superman movie. Those are my top five Superman films. And not Superman 3 and Superman, I mean, Superman 3 and Supergirl were not the bad movies. They were not bad, but Superman 4, The Quest for Peace was just god-awful movie. And this movie fucking sucks! It sucks so bad! It sucks! This movie sucks! Now, since this came out, the first off, this is the end of Christopher Reeve era, and it's sad. This is actually Christopher Reeve's final movie. It was actually his final movie that he did, and he wrote a story for this movie, and his story sucked. Yeah, he wrote a fucking story for this movie. But let's talk how this movie came out, how this movie was actually made. So back in 90, back I think was 1974. I kind of forgot, in my review when I reviewed Superman the movie, I know exactly. But I think was 1970, 74. I think was somewhere there. Ilya Sarkand and his purchased the rights for Superman by DC Comic Books, with his father Alexander Sarkand, and bought the rights. I think he had to fight to gain the rights for the Superman films, for the Superman character on the DC Comics. And of course, that's actually was successful. So with Richard Donner, they made Superman the movie. And that time, Superman the movie became a hit. They fired Richard Donner because they didn't agree with his approach for the sequel, Superman 2. So Richard Lester came aboard and they did the Superman 2. Superman 2 was actually less successful as the first movie, but they made more money. Superman 3 was actually the final film in the trilogy. Superman 3 was actually a failure. I think it was a commercial and critics failure because of Richard Pryor, and because it was way too much humoristic and comedy in it. So the Sarkinds, they did Supergirl, which is a spin-off of the Superman movie. And it was set after Superman 3, because they filmed in 1983 but released in 1984. I think because they could not get it out the whole cut, there was like a 50 or 60 minutes cut out of that film, and it was in because Supergirl was a failure, you know, it was a completely failure, box office disappointment, a failure, you know. The Salkinds sold the rights in 1986. They actually went and sold the rights for Superman to Cannon Group, you know, I forgot what was those two owners' name already. I think was Menahem Golan and Joran Globus Cannon Group Inc. The Salkinds sold the rights for Superman to Joran Globus and Cannon Group Inc. And by the time in 1986, you know, when they bought the rights, the Cannon Group were actually they were actually in financial troubles, which means they ran out of money. The company was completely ran out of money. They were in financial trouble in the mid 80s. That means in the 80s, 1986. So that when they bought the rights for Superman, you know, they hoped this film will actually save them, you know, the finished picture. They thought that this movie will save them, you know. They were sure this movie will save them from bankruptcy, because the Cannon Group were in several financial troubles that time, you know, and they were in a huge trouble, and of course, So they thought, Menahem Golan and Joran Globus were sure that this movie will save them, you know, will bring them more money, will save them. But sadly, that did not happen. You know, this movie actually ruined them. This movie bring them on the end of bankruptcy, which they completely lost their company. They were completely lost everything, you know. So the finished picture end up been another costly failure. So that was the problem with this film, you know. They completely this Superman 4, The Quest for Peace, went and it pushed the Cannon Groupers into door of under the door of bankruptcy. So they lost everything, you know. Poor producers, you know. Yes, I feel bad for them. They lost everything. This movie destroyed them. The original budget was actually $36 million, but it was actually cut on $17 million, you know. Even the cheaply effects, because they thought, you know, from 2 hours 4 minutes, you know, I think was 134 minutes long, you know. They actually cut for 1 hour 30 minutes long film. I think it was 2 hours. I think this movie should be long 2 hour 14 minutes, but they cut, you know, they went and they cut to they I think they cut 47 minutes in the film, which came out 1 hour 30 minutes, because they thought this movie is gonna be successful. They also cut the budget, they also cut the scenes, you know, they made cheap effects, you know. They were very cheap effects, so they thought that this is gonna save them, but it actually end their career. It completely collide and destroyed the company, you know, completely destroyed company. So that's how this movie was made, you know. It was made out of money and greed, because they thought it's gonna save the company, but it actually ruined the company instead. It completely financially completely ruined the company. And Superman: The Quest for Peace is one of the worst Superman movies of all time. I mean, everyone who says that is right. Superman 4 is the worst Superman movie of all time. This movie was bombed by critics and fans, which was a commercial and critic failure. It was a failure from the beginning. This movie suffers from so bad, god-awful special effects, terrible cheap lines, plot holes, way too much plot holes. This film has way too much plot holes, terrible acting performance, horrendous character development. You know, this movie was horrendous. You know, it was just, you know, this was just from beginning till end was just bad movie. You know, and they used the John Williams music score, but hearing John music score in this movie was just bad. It was god awful. You know, I think directed was been by Sidney J. Fury, and according to Margot Kidder, Christopher Reeve and Sidney J. Fury did not get along in this movie. Wes Craven was supposed to approach to direct this film, but because Christopher Reeve did not like him, you know, he left the project. You know, Christopher Reeve demanded another new, I think was new director. You know, so yeah, so Sidney J. Fury get along, but he did not get along with Christopher Reeve at all. Margot Kidder, Christopher Long did not get along. They non-stop complaining. They non-stop. They went and arguing during the making the film. And Margot Kidder claimed that that Christopher Reeve's ego was actually in the way because he wrote the co-story for this film. It is really bad. It is a shame. You know, Christopher Reeve said that the better the less he talks about this film, better it is, you know. But I think he was disappointed when this movie was released, and also knows that everyone knows that this movie was a cheap crap piece of pile garbage shit movie. I got headaches from this movie. It was so bad. I got headaches. I had to took a pill. Yeah, it's true. It was so. This is the last time I'm watching this movie. I am staying away. Thank God I did not bought this movie in collection. You know, I don't have this movie collection. This movie won't kill near my collection because I hate this film. I hate Superman IV, The Quest for Peace. I hate this film. I hate this film so much, you know. This movie is a piece of shit movie. So I hate this movie. You know, this movie sucks so badly. Sucks. This was the worst superhero movie ever. The worst movie of Superman. The worst superhero movie ever. It was so bad, awful. It has so many mistakes, plot holes, childish acting performance by everyone. I mean, what was Christopher Reeve thinking about making this film? You know, maybe Margot Kidder was right. You know, maybe it was his ego in his way. You know. That he wrote up huge ego when he co-wrote the story for this film. Came out in 97. This movie came out in 97. Little Weapon, miles way better than this garbage. You know, Little Weapon 97 is a pure epic, phenomenal classic. This is a pile of shit movie. You know. Directed by Sidney J. Fury. You. Sidney J. Fury. You blew it, man. You blew it. Your movie blew it. You blew it, man. You know. And like, there were this movie was based on a three writers. I mean, for the story, Christopher Reeve, Lawrence Connor, and Mark Rosenthal. They wrote the story for this movie, for this awful movie. And the screenplay was by Lawrence Connor and Mark Rosenthal, but it was just god awful. You know. The movie was just with cheap effects, you know. It's not even a guilty pleasure of mine, and I would that some people liked it. I could not stand this film. I cannot stand this film. It was just, oh my god, this was just, oh. Oh my god. Oh my god. What the hell happened to this film? So, let's go to the story, how the story begins. So, after the credits, they're like Russians in a space, and we see Superman flying in a cheap costume, in a cheap effect. And the flying segment, excuse me, the flying segment itself was actually so cheaply dated. You can see unrealistic, you know. I think I'm gonna throw up after seeing this movie. I think I'm gonna just throw up after seeing this movie. I hope not, but I'm really gonna show up because it was so. This movie was pure puke. Oh, this was a puke of a film. A puke of a film, you know. So after seeing Superman seeing these astronauts in a trouble, Russians, he goes and saves them. And I didn't know that Superman speaks Russian. I had no idea that he also knows all the languages, which I didn't know, because in the all three Superman movies, I had not even seen speaking him Russian. So he goes saves the astronauts. And I also didn't know that in Metropolis, there's also a subway station. I did not know that. And we see Margot Kidder, now old as Lois Lane. She goes in a train, and like, I mean, so this guy who was driving the train has like a heart failure or a seizure and falls down. And they wanted you, oh, every accident is now Superman has to save. And Lois Lane is the only one who finds out that the train is speeding, and she keeps screaming, "Help! Help!" And I was like, what? You're not even in trouble. The train's speeding. And Superman goes, stops the train, and he keeps, oh, the train station still safe. All the safe. You know, oh my God. What the fuck? This movie. Oh my God. Oh. I will never watch this movie again. Never. The final time. You know, I'm glad I downloaded this film that I did not pay even a cent. I paid for this movie. Thank God I don't have it. I remember seeing in my high school years, I saw the VHS for this film in a video store. I never purchased it. I never cared about this film. So thank God I never bought it. You know, I saw the DVD for the first movie, but I saw for Superman 4 the VHS. I don't remember, I saw this film as a kid. I don't remember that much as a kid liking this film. But this movie gave me a god-awful headaches, you know. Oh my God. Superman the Quest for Peace fucking sucks. What happened with this movie? So, now we see the prison scene. And we see John Cryer. He also did. He stated that he liked working with Gene Hackman and Christopher Reeve. And John Cryer was he played Lex Luthor in Supergirl. I think it was in season 4. Yeah, it was in season 4. I think it was season 4, season 5. He played Lex Luthor. He still guest star as Lex Luthor. John Cryer, who pl he played, he plays Lenny, the cousin of Lex Luthor. Lex is now in this outfit, or in the prison outfit, you know. And Lenny shows up and helps him. The two guards are so stupid to watch his car. They go in the car with a remote control, which is impossible. Drives and falls off the cliff, but there's no explosion. And those two stupid guards are still alive, which just fucking sucks, you know. So now Lenny and Lex wants to plot revenge against Superman. So he breaks into Superman Museum, steals the hair of Superman. Which I know why the fuck was even hair in the first place, but he steals the hair of Superman. He goes and steals the hair of Superman, and now Superman is decides to do quest for peace because the peace mission. This stupid fucking kid, Jeremy, played by retarded kid Damian McLeod-Horne, you know, because his fucking retarded school is talking about nuclear physics and nuclear weapons and what they should do to vote a congressman. And this asshole kid says, Jeremy, oh, I'm gonna write a kid outline of this Superman. And this asshole kid does that, sends to Daily Planet, sends the fucking letter, you know. And And of course, now Daily Planet has been taken over by David Warfeld, which is actually a new owner of Daily Planet. He bought the rights for Daily Planet, and he took the rights for Daily Planet with his daughter Lacey Warfeld, played by Marielle Hemingway. They took the Daily Planet, you know, they took the rights, the Daily Planet, and of course Jackie Cooper is completely ugly in this movie and old. It's just abomination, you know. So after buying the Daily Planet, David Warfield has an idea to take this kid, you know. To talk with this kid, and he makes him to star, in which they go and criticize Superman because Superman says no to a kid, you know. So Superman decides to respect the kid's wishes. He has no choice, but Man of Steel has to go and respect this kid's wishes, and he decides that he's gonna help, you know, by making this planet safe. I had no idea that Superman is also a politician, because if I remember in the first movie, you know, Kal-El's biological father says that he's not he Superman cannot interfere in the people's in the people's problems. And Superman is not a politician, if I know, but this movie, he is a politician. This is another thing that's wrong with this picture. So now all over the world they find those rockets, those missiles, and Superman grabs them. He like collects them with a fake costume, fake boots, you know. He goes and collects them, and he throws them in the sun. There's another rocket that is actually fired by Lex Luthor, who breaks the museum, steals a hair, and he creates a nuclear man. When Superman catches the he goes and catches the missile and throws the missile in the and he throws the missile in the sun. Nuclear Man is created and goes to Lex Luthor, which I still know how Nuclear Man know that Lex Luthor was the one that he designed with Superman's hair. I still don't know how Nuclear Man know where to went, or how it was even created, or how was even his costume created. I just don't understand the comic issue is with this garbage about Nuclear Man. Yeah, it's based on Atom Man, on the Superman radio, but I don't know if it's Nuclear Man even exists in comic books. You know, I think it was later after this release of this film was actually Nuclear Man writing on it. But the plot for Nuclear Man makes no sense, you know. So we've now found out by Lex, you know, according to Lex and Nuclear Man, that Nuclear Man only if he's touched with sun, you know, he is alive, but without the sun, I mean, without the sun, he's useless, you know, which Lex, you know, says that he's a father. And Nuclear Man is played by Mark Pillow, which is his only film. And Mark Pillow, I'm sorry, but you suck, buddy. You're terrible. I mean, was your voice dubbed or something? The acting performance is just terrible, you know. Boy, this movie was bad. This movie was just bad. So, in the meantime, Lacey Wayfield decides to flirt with Superman, to flirt with Clark Kent. And meantime, you know, Clark and Lacey are in this fitness club. And this guy is asshole, and it's just there's even a scene in which he's riding a Smallville, or like we don't know it's a Smallville on a Kent farm, and Clark wanted to sell it, but then decided not to sell it. Oh. Oh my God, this was just god awful performance by Christopher Reeve, god awful film. Yeah, I have a headings because of this movie, because I watched this movie. This is the last time I am staying away from this movie. I'm done with this movie. I'm done. I don't want to see this movie ever again, you know. Oh my God. I have to go. I have to breathe and take a breath, you know. I talked to a polar bear in the fuck nuclear waste, you know. Oh my God, Superman for the Quest for Peace was just terrible, 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 terrible. It got me such a god awful headaches. Oh my God. So Lex now shows up with his fucking face in this in the TV widescreen, and only man who still can see it, and he calls him out that he's gonna blow the building. Superman shows up, and I still don't know what the fuck was Superman waiting. He didn't do anything. Like in the first movie, he grabbed Lex Luthor. In this movie, he didn't do anything. He was just waiting until the appearance of Nuclear Man, and Nuclear Man challenges Superman to a fight and fly around. Like Superman is now grabbing the star. No, Nuclear Man grabs that statue from Liberty Island. It's supposed to be Metropolis, not New York, you know. They actually filmed, I think, in New York. So he uses that statue. He uses like that. He uses the statue. He also uses that walls, destroy them, while Superman builds them so back, which is impossible for Superman to build them so back. Watch Superman 3, you know. While Nuclear Man destroyed the wall, you know, in that castle. Superman may like magicianly, somehow with magicians, he just magicianly puts the bricks back. That's impossible. Watch Superman 3 on that oil tanker when he make a hole in that oil. Watch he use in that movie. I forgot another thing which I completely forgot it. In this movie, Superman, I don't know, he doesn't even use that much heat vision like he did in the previous Superman movies, you know. Yeah, he does use freezing breath, but he doesn't use that freezing cooler he uses. But in Superman 3, he used a heat vision, while in this movie he used like with his mouth, you know. He like used and he like magicianly, on magic way, he built the brick so fast back. Which I just don't get it. Now Nuclear Man goes causes somehow explosion on the volcano. There's a lavine, and now Superman goes and makes like his cooler vision, and it's just I just don't get this film. Oh my God, I just don't get this film. Oh, I don't get this film. Oh my God. Oh. The more I talk, more I get awful headaches. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Superman Quest. Oh my God. Oh. You know, even my dog, she knows this movie was piece of garbage, pile of crap. You know, it's a she dog, which I love my dog so much. Even she knows this is a piece of garbage movie. Such a fucking lame excuse of a film, you know. I don't know what the fuck was with these fucking filmmakers to make such a pile of shit movie. This is not even a guilty pleasure of mine. It's not guilty of pleasure of mine, you know. Superman 4, Quest for Peace fucking sucks. It sucks. Sidney J. Furie is terrible director, you know. No wonder they hired him. How much was he paid for this bullshit movie? You know. So Superman, during the stupid battle, he grabs I think that this idiot Nuclear Man was carrying this Liberty statue, you know, Liberty statue, and Superman grabs the Liberty Statue back, and like Nuclear Man has this claws on it, and he goes and he cuts like a cat, cuts Superman, and Superman, you know, he falls down, and of course now Nuclear Man grabs and kicks him with his foot, and Superman flies. We see a cape, you know, and I think that they the Wayfield went and like, oh, the death of Superman. They wrote the death of Superman. You know, oh my god, this movie was piece of shit movie. This movie fucking sucks. And Lois shows up and gets all pissed, you know, because she has rights to it. You know, she said this is way too far. She grabs the cape out of it, you know. Oh my gosh. And yeah, and David says to fire Clark Kent. He didn't show up to work. Lois shows up to Clark. Clark is now like sick. Why was he sick? Why is Clark in this movie sick? Explain to me what? Why is he sick? And oh, Lois says, oh, I always love him. That's how he loves him. And the next scene is like Superman is fucking old and dying, and he uses the glowing crystal. Why is his Superman dying? I thought that Kryptonite can kill Superman, but not Nuclear Man. Nuclear Man shouldn't be the one that should hurt Superman, you know. I just don't get it. And I don't know why Nuclear Man was then trying to get Lacey. How did Superman know that Nuclear Man wants Lacey? He flies there, causes a panic and scares the people. How did he know that? How did Superman know that Superman, and like Nuclear Man said, give me the woman. And why Superman knows? How the fuck Superman knows what the fuck he was talking about? No, oh my god, this garbage movie, this god awful piece of stinker garbage movie. This movie stinks. It stinks. And now Nuclear Man goes, causes the destruction, you know. Oh, those people who hate Man of Steel, why don't you watch this film? You know, oh, Man still has destruction. This movie has destruction. And Superman doesn't do anything. He just stands there like a chicken shit, you know, and doesn't do anything while Nuclear Man wipes everything, you know. Why Nuclear Man wants Lacey Wayfield? What will he do with Lacey? Why? Was he in love with her? Did he want that she wrote him a story? I don't get this movie. This movie has so many plot holes. And now Nuclear Man, you know, destroys all the building, and Superman tries to protect her. But I mean, I don't get this movie. I don't get this piece of shit movie. You know, it has so many plot holes. Nuclear Man grabs Lacey. And they fly in the sky, they fly in the space, and I still don't know how the hell is Lacey alive. I think the AC, Lacey would actually lose oxygen, you know, because in space there's no oxygen. So I think she would died. And Superman grabs a stone and covers the sun. I still don't get it. I think that if Superman would actually cover the stone, I mean, not the stone, with the stone, the yellow sun, I think that Superman's powers would be also lost, because the yellow sun gives Superman power. But in this movie, Nuclear Man loses powers, and so does Superman. And he flies back so far on the Earth, Lacey, and there's no explanation, because Lacey then disappears from the movie. It's no explanation what happened to Lacey. So he goes back, but there's he goes back, you know, I think he also grabs that elevator, you know, elevator shows in the moon, but by that time, you know, the sun goes back, and of course, Nuclear Man goes back, like I said, kidnaps Lacey, goes in the space, because I think that in space she will be dead. We need oxygen. There was no oxygen, no air, no oxygen in the space. Lacey will be dead. Nothing, no explanation what happened later to the actress, to the character, nothing. Oh my god. So now they're on the moon, you know, Superman and Nuclear Man fight each other they both go and fight each other in the moon. That's the only scene that I did like, the fight at the moon. I liked it, you know. I liked the fight when Superman grabs a knee, he gives a knee to Mark Pillow. I liked that. That scene, I liked it. What I didn't like was like Nuclear Man, you know, grabs him in the dirt, you know, the moon, kicks his butt, you know, and flies on the earth. That scene I hated. But then Superman, he goes back, fights again, Nuclear Man, and he shows him now. He goes and shows him in the nuclear reactor in the plant. And Nuclear Man gets killed, and then of course we find out that Jackie Cooper, who plays Perry White, you know, he went to all the banks to loan, and he bought the share for Daily Planet, and he outnumbered David Warfield, you know. And Superman catches Lex Luthor and Lenny that try to escape. He goes, you know, and catches. He brings, I think, to institution Lenny. He grabs and brings Lex, and those prisoners says, "Oh, the buzzard's back!" The buzzard is back. I was like laughing my ass off for the scene there, and Paris and scene, you know. And I love when Jim Hammond says, "Shut up!" He says, "Shut up" to all of them, you know. Thank God the buzzard is back, and Lex like, "Shut up! How did you say? How did you beat him?" And Superman is old school, high school, still 30. Oh my God. So there was like this ridiculous scene in which Superman and Clark Kent have date with Lacey and Lois, and I forgot to mention, and there is a comedy in it, you know. There are so many comedy elements, like he completely fool out of himself, you know. He was like So like he was on the he jumped on the luggage. He was like, oh my God. I think that Christopher Reeve embarrassed himself because those scenes are so embarrassing. I just don't get it. The movie fucking ends. I don't get this fucking movie. This movie, man, really exhausted me, exhausted my energy, my intelligence. Is this movie so low, or we're just people so or we're just people our IQ became so low, or we people just so dumb, you know? So what were they thinking? What was Christopher Reeve thinking? Yeah, then the movie ends. Superman flies again with the footage from the first three movies, and the movie ends with John Williams' score. What were they thinking? No explanation what happened with no explanation what happened with to Lacey Wayfield. She disappears from the film, you know. I don't get this film. I don't get it. I'm blabbering about 40 minutes, you know, making a movie review rant. It's a rant on Superman, the quest for peace. Because this just, oh my God. Anyway, I am finishing. I finished the Superman movies. No, I will not review Superman Returns, Batman Beyond Justice, or Justice League Way. I don't care. This movie took all my energy. You know, I took to Paul Bears into fuck nuclear waste, you know. It took my energy. This is my final movie review, my final video on Superman. I'm done with I'm done. It's not, ooh, one bad movie. Superman Returns, I have the same problem. Batman Superman Down Justice, I will explode. I will explode. I don't wanna explode in front camera, so no. Justice League Way, I can't stand it. I can't stand those three movies. I barely make it this movie. It was only 1 hour 29 minutes long. You know. Canon Group, I mean, Canon Group, you know, they don't have that much bad films, you know. Cobra, I enjoy. I love Cobra. I love Cobra. I enjoy, I love Cobra, you know. Wait. I actually do have the poster of Cobra, you know. I do have the poster of Cobra. Yeah, I do have the poster of Cobra, which I do really enjoy this film. So the Canon Group, they don't have that many bad films, you know. I enjoy Cobra, you know. Obviously, many people do enjoy. I enjoy Cobra, but you know. Stallone, The Strong Arm of Law, Cobra from Canon Group with Warner Brothers. I enjoy this film, you know. I enjoy this film. Obviously, I enjoy Masters of the Universe with Dolph Lundgren. I enjoy and love Bloodsport, Kickboxer, Cyborg. I enjoy those three movies with Van Damme. I enjoy Highlander, which is also part of Canon Group production. Like I said, Cobra, I enjoy Cobra, you know, Cobra, I enjoy and I love Over the Top with Stallone, which is another Canon Group production. I love Murphy's Law, Death Wish 2, 3, and 4, I love Murphy's Law, I love and enjoy, what are more movies that I remember with Canon Group. I don't remember the other movies then. Missing in Action trilogy I enjoy. I enjoy Invasion USA with Chuck Norris. Obviously, a lot of people enjoy Chuck Norris movies. Yes, I like American Ninja 1 and 2, with Michael Dudikoff. I actually love those two movies today. They're great movies. You know, so Canon Group, they did not have bad movies, you know. But this was just bad, awful. Superman 4, you know, caused them and ended their studio, you know. They lost money. This movie... you know, this movie just throw them into nothing but it just throw them into a bankruptcy, you know. So that's what happened to this film, you know. That's what happened. But anyway, that's my rant on Superman for the Quest for Peace. I'm done. I'm exhausted. This movie was just terrible, you know. Just bad, awful. It was just terrible. It was a disappointment. It was a piece of crap, a garbage movie, a trash movie, a piece of trash movie. You know, I can't even watch it. One of the worst movies of all time, the worst Superman movie ever made. You know, and people are complaining about Man of Steel. Man of Steel is a masterpiece compared to this garbage. You know. Anyway. That's my rant on Superman 4, The Quest for Peace, came out in 97. It made worldwide $15 million, which was commercial and box office failure. It was a completely... Oh, yeah. You know, like, was actually criticized and blamed by using cheap visual effects, which is true, inconsistency, lack of originality, plot holes. You know, the movie lacks of originality. It has tons of plot holes, you know. The character development is terrible. Yeah. The film was critical and commercial failure. It was box office failure. It was commercial failure. It was critical failure. This movie has been considered one of the worst Superman movies of all time, the worst superhero movie of all time, which is true. It's the worst one, you know. And yeah, I don't agree with Chris Tuckman, who said that Cannon Group had bad movies. I disagree, you know. Like I said, I love this film. I love this film. So no, this movie is not bad. I love this film, you know. So yes, I love this film. I love this film. I love, like I said, I love this film. Missing in Action trilogy. I enjoy Invasion USA, American Ninja 1 and 2. I enjoy Murphy's Law, Cobra. I just mentioned and show you that poster. I enjoy Over the Top with Stallone, which I love that Over the Top. I enjoy those movies, you know. I really enjoy those movies, you know. Cobra, I love from Cannon Group. Cyborg, Kickboxer, Bloodsport with Van Damme. I do really enjoy those movies, which I don't think that Cannon Group had bad movies, you know. But this wasn't just bad movie. This is just terrible movie, just god awful movie. On IMDb, it got 3.7, which no wonder why it got 3.7 IMDb, because it was so god awful, you know. And the critics who panned and mauled this movie are actually right, you know. Critical and commercial failure, you know. You know, Cannon lent out the money during the production, so this film was critical and commercial failure. And the effects were, the flying scenes were cheap visual effects. Like non-stop was Superman was like flying the same time, you know. It was cheap visual effects, you know. The effects are laughable. Everything about this movie was laughable, you know. This movie lacks of originality. It has plot holes, too many plot holes. Terrible idea, horrible character development. You know, it's just terrible. This movie was just god awful, you know. I would rather watch this film, you know. Rather watch this film, Cobra. Rather watch this film, Cobra. Yeah. Superman 4, The Quest for Peace, stars Christopher Reeve, Margot Kidder, Mariel Hemingway, Gene Hackman, Sam Wanamaker, rest in peace, John Cryer, and Mark Pillow, directed by Sidney J. Furie and written by Christopher Reeve, and Christopher Reeve, Lawrence Conner, and Mark Rosenthal. And the movie was released 24 July 1987. You know, movie's original budget was $36 million, but because they were actually financially troubled, they went in the split. They actually slashed the budget into half, into $70 million for making this movie. You know, by using a cheap visual effects. You know. And making too many to cut this movie from 47 minutes into 130 minutes, you know, without explanation what happened, without any explanation, without that terrible cheap effects, you know. I mean, you know, what could have been better if the movie were more focused on creating Nuclear Man and more action scenes, like the Fire at the Moon scene? It could have been much better. More better executed, you know. This movie was bad, was terrible executed, you know. That's one of my problems for this film. I think, but yeah, I calm myself down now, so I calm myself down now, so that's my rant on Superman 4, The Quest for Peace. Sorry for the yelling and screaming, but this movie really exhausted me. But when I finish the ending, I'm actually more better, so I'm really happy for it. So thanks so much for subscribing, and there'll be new videos. I'm still planning to do my thoughts on Smallville, but I don't know if I'll do that today. At least I won't. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'm out.